might be the right order. Well, when this method was invented by Jacobi more than 150 years ago, notice that this involved hand calculations. So, you know, the calculations were performed by his student, Seidel, and you can imagine that Seidel would want to reduce the sum of the squares of the off-diagonal elements as much as possible for every time he does computation, because doing this by hand takes a lot of time. So what he, and the other thing is, they could only do this for very small matrices, because, you know, you're not going to do 100 by 100 or 1,000 by 1,000 matrix by hand. So at that time, it paid to say, I'm going to scan all of the off-diagonal entries. I'm going to find the one that's largest in magnitude. I'm going to zero that one out. I'm going to update my matrix. And then I'm going to search for the next largest entry in magnitude, zero that one out. In the process, I may actually take a zero and make it non-zero, but that's okay. And then I want to repeat that until my matrix becomes approximately diagonal. And if I then accumulate all of the Jacobi rotations just right, then I have my eigenvectors and I have my eigenvalues. Well, if you do this with a very large matrix, then searching for the largest off-diagonal element, you know, if you do it naively, would require order n squared, or order m squared, I should say, if this is an m by m matrix, order m squared searching. Okay, and then you end up modifying two rows and two columns. That's order m computation. So now you're doing order m squared searching for order m useful computation. Maybe not such a good strategy. And moreover, you're hopping all over this matrix. So the way it's done in practice, typically, is through a cyclic method. And what's a cyclic method? Well, a column cyclic Jacobi method will say, I'm just going to be very organized about it. I'm going to zero this one out first, then this one, then this one, then this one, then this one, then this one. At that point, I've zeroed out every off-diagonal pair once. That's called a sweep of the Jacobi method. And then you go back to the beginning and you do it again and again and again. And you can prove that if you do a column cyclic Jacobi method, that actually that will converge. Okay. And it's a beautifully simple algorithm. It comes back in vogue periodically because it exhibits a lot of parallelism if you do it just right. It's generally considered to be quite a bit slower than the QR algorithm, and therefore it's not utilized all that much. It was shown that it actually has very, very nice numerical stability properties. So it turns out to be a highly accurate method. And yeah, it's kind of a nice link to the past that allows us to relate a lot of things that we've done to something that's a little bit different.